Good evening, everybody. My name's Jackie Bros.
And I'm Dunlap.
We want to thank you for winding down with us here on Evenin Folks. Appreciate y'all joining us.
Take a load off.
Well, it's
calm even.
Calm down.
Just lay down on the couch there. Take you a couple of your pills.
Don't take no pills.
Welcome to Evenin Folks. I just thought that maybe you were, when you talk about it, you're like, roll that wagon wheel up here and lean it up against the shed.
I think
what we need is a more modern take on Evenin Folks.
I never said one thing about a wagon wheel since I've been doing this. Don't tell people what to do. People have different ways of winding down themselves. They got different ways. Ought not be taking pills if that's your way. You need to talk to your doctor about that. Shouldn't be doing that. But other than that, you kick your feet up or sit up straight. Don't tell people how to do it. Some people eating dinner right now. TV dinner, sitting there looking at the computer.
Take your dinner over to the couch and get comfortable. Don't sit at the table.
Take your
seat like old-fashioned putting on airs.
Take your
plate and sit on the couch. Get in the easy chair. Throw it back. Put your feet up. That's how you watch.
Sit wherever you want. Don't listen to him. Let's get on with eating, folks. Sorry, I had to hear all that.
Get in the bed and eat your
supper. If they want to get in the bed, they will. Don't tell people what to do.
I bet you worked all day.
Some people work a night shift. This is what the evening folks went.
That's the first thing.
Well, to them it is, but to us it's still evening to everybody
eggs
else.
Eggs and bacon
all
for
right,
supper.
Just
idiots.
Shut up. Don't call nobody an idiot. You the idiot. Don't ever run your mouth. All right, we're going to get on with evening folks. First off, we got a good thing. Got started. Happy to do it again. It's substitute school bus driver. Yeah, all right. Substitute school bus driver. This is just to help children so they'll be aware of their surroundings. Then if it's a stranger and they don't want to get on the, you know, make sure the right person is behind the wheel. That's what you should do with every school bus, as far as I'm concerned. And that's what we're doing right here.
Right, because more children are kidnapped by fake school buses than in any other manner.
Well, it mean it could happen. You don't know. It should. If you raise your child right.
No. If I was gonna kidnap children, I'd go steal me a school bus and ride up and down the roads of a small town where everybody knows everybody.
No.
And that's how I'd load up on them and I'd take them off to my little compound.
Shut your mouth. They ain't talking no kid to no compound. It happened in Dirty Harry, that's happened on there. You don't have to go so far like Forrest Gump did. And Mama made him, you know, what's your name, bus driver? They ain't got every child ain't got time to do that. Of course, he went to special school. But, you know, we had to raise him up a certain way. But children can't do that every time. Ask the name, introduce themselves. They ain't got all, you got to get them on the bus and get
Why
them home.
Why not? That gives them social skills.
All right.
Gives them a little
Ziggler. They can have social skills, but they'll be late getting to school. That what they need to learn is at school. They'll get plenty of social skills there. That's where they're supposed to be. So this morning, or next morning, not this morning, tomorrow morning, it says here, Dot Llewellyn, it says here, oh, bless her heart, says she has a fever, a sore throat. Oh, good Lord. He got a headache. Sounds like she got all of it there. That's pitiful. But she got to go to the doctor, which she need to, with all that going on. She says, what's something wrong with her? Well, sore throat, headache, a fever, and something, her feet ain't right, or something wrong with feet. Anyway, it says here, so what they did, they called up, okay, Toby Gilly is going to be, they called him up. Now, he's about 6 foot, says here, 6 foot tall, slender man, brown hair, short brown hair. But now look, he says he hurt his driving finger and he can't be there.
Then why did you tell people what he looked like?
Well, it says here, that's what he was supposed to be on the bus, and now that it ain't. He ain't going to be on the bus.
So if he shows up on the bus, you'll know something's wrong?
Well, he ain't supposed to be. Let me just do. I'm trying to do substitute school bus driver. Let people know. He says here, hurt his driving finger. Must have mashed his finger somehow. I don't know. It said don't say.
How do you think he did that?
It don't say how he did it. I'm just assuming you usually mash your finger
so
somehow.
So you go through everything that's a matter with Dot Llewellyn down to her feet.
Well, that's what it says
and
here.
He mashes his finger, which you could say in that one sentence, like, freezer door.
Oh, wait, don't. But I don't. It don't say freezing door, so it ain't up to me to speculate how he mashed his finger.
This is all over the map.
All right, just let me get through this. So Toby Gelly, he hurt his driving finger, can't be there. So Jeannie Roberts is going to fill in for him, and she's got curly blonde hair, wears glasses, says she's medium build, about 5'4". That's this bus 14 or out 17. All that right there. It's not Dot. It ain't Toby. It's going to be Jeannie. Blonde hair, wear glass, medium build. Also here, bus 22. Well, wait a minute. Okay, Jeannie Roberts going to fill in for him. Curly blonde. Okay, I didn't get all the descriptions. She'll be wearing camouflage cutoffs and a purple sleeveless T-shirt. It says here. Oh, and the password. Here's the password to get on bus 14 or out 17. It is 12MH8, paired Q, sassafras, milk, alleviate 7. So that's the password if you're not sure enough about it, Jeannie. If it does something seem off, just ask her a password. She'll tell you. It's one. Let's do it one more time. 12MH8, paired Q, sassafras, milk, alleviate 7. That's your password there if you're going to get on bus 14, route 17. Also says here, like I said, is bus 22, and this is a Humboldt Road route. Ernie Hall's taking that over. Y'all know him. Everybody knows him. No way. Yeah. So that's...
Wait a minute.
What? Don't start.
Why don't you have to tell people what Ernie Hall looks like?
Everybody knows Ernie Hall around. Everybody knows him, knows what he looks like. I ain't got to go in there.
I don't know what he looks like.
Well, you ain't getting on the bus. I hope not. It ain't none of your concern what he looks like. Don't you worry about it.
I woke up in stranger places.
Oh, hell.
Wait a minute. I do know what he looks like. With jolly red face.
That's, everybody knows Ernie Hall.
All right.
Good
You're
Lord
right.
Almighty. That's substitute. A school bus driver.
That came on.
Just enough of all this. I get tired. There's no point in it. Just shut it up. All right, snake of the day, number one. Snake of the day has come from a good friend. Supposed to say this good friends at Cuddle Buddies.
Now, just to catch people up, if maybe they didn't say yesterday's
Don't
want to
spend
folks.
Any more time on it than
just
I have to.
Just real quick, it was supposed to be pet of the day. Jackie went down to Cuddle Buddies, talked to Julie down there. He thought he was getting a bunch of pictures of cats and fluffy little puppies. Yeah. But it turns out you signed something. You were forced into an agreement. I'm confused.
I thought I was signing one thing, and I guess she thought I signed something else. She threw that piece of paper in my face. I don't know how many.
Why did you have to sign anything just to talk about
it? Well, yes, you do it something on a computer. You use somebody's name. I just want to be official.
There's some sort of legal agreement. That you have to talk about snakes on every one of them?
I have to. What I want to do is find home for little dogs and kid cats. That's all I want to do. I thought there's nothing, no harm in that. You're doing a service trying to help them out and do the job. So I went down there and asked Julie. She said, that sounded like a good idea, but I guess she thought I was talking about something else. I guess maybe she's partial to the snakes down there and don't care about the dogs. I have no idea. But she said she can hold over me in a court of law. I talked to Bill, I talked to Ted, and they said nothing they can do about it. Of course, I don't think, Bill's higher up than her. Ted ain't so much. I don't think he couldn't do nothing about it anyway, but I just complained and he was around and he heard me. But so, Julie, I'm going to look into this some more. This ain't the end of it, but right now, we're going to do what I said it's going to do, even though I didn't know that's what I was saying I was going to do. But here it is. Snake of the day one, it's a cobra. Name is Tino.
Now, hold on a minute.
Why?
Do you really think they got a cobra down there?
It's Julie's snake of the day. That's what it is. I don't know what that else could be. I know, she just wants me to put up pictures of snakes. I wouldn't think that's all it would. That's a waste of time, I think.
Well, I'm pretty sure they ain't got a cobra down there.
Well, it says here, I don't want to spend any more time on this than I have to. It's a cobra named Tino. That's it. And a snake of the day.
Julie is pulling pictures of snakes off the internet just to mess with you. I don't know what you did to Julie.
I didn't do nothing to her. I went down there trying to help.
But that is not a snake they have in stock. I will guarantee you that. Maybe. I don't know. I'd be surprised.
Volunteer down there. She don't even get paid. I volunteer our time here on Evening Folks to help them do a service for a community. It's what I want to do. Instead, I'm doing this. I don't know if I got, she just partial snakes down there. If I got these many snakes down there, I guess I need a home.
If they had a cobra, is that even legal to try to give it away?
What?
A cobra?
A cobra.
Got to be illegal.
I don't know first thing about having snakes. I don't know anything about legal. The only thing I know legal is she got me my name on some paper and I got to show a picture of whatever snake she want me to.
So that's snake of the day. Jackie.
Did
you hear the news?
It's
That'd
awful.
Be a good segue for that, for the news section of this. Hey, Jackie, did you hear the news?
News always awful. Just said it. Yeah,
a little routine like that. That's good. Keep that, too. How about how awful it is?
It is awful. Hold Everything on. Ain't nothing going
hey,
on. Don't just.
Did you hear the news?
Just do it.
Clint Eastwood. Do you remember Clint Eastwood?
I know who Clint Eastwood is.
Well, he is in trouble.
Trouble?
He is in trouble with the liberal blogosphere.
Oh, he don't give a...
Because they did a big interview, him and his son.
Which one?
In Suicide Squad. How many sons has he got?
He got a lot of children.
Like 15.
Something like that. There's a lot of them. To each his own. I ain't judging that. But, you know, he got the money to take care of them, so, yeah.
He's also, I'm just going to say, got the money for condoms.
Hey, what?
I would imagine. Plus, that would be a great story. You know who I sold a pack of rubbers to?
Just
Clint
shut
Eastwood.
Your mouth. I don't want to talk about
and
that on
you
here.
Know that's what he said. He would walk in there and say, give me a pack of rubbers.
Oh, shut your mouth. I don't want
you know
to hear about him doing any of that stuff. He
Clint
got
Eastwood never said the word condom.
Yeah. If he did an interview with his... son, he seemed like he could do an interview with all the children. Sounded to me like he's picking favorites. The rest of them probably jealous, but so be it. That's his family, ain't mine. I'm staying keep my nose out of it.
Give me a pack of rubbers.
All right, I'm not going to listen to that. I'll just...
Unless I can talk her out of it.
Just...
Let's see what all he said. So he's talking... Jackie, you love Clint Eastwood so much. I forgot his name. You love Clint Eastwood so much. What's that movie he made? He made a movie about a flood. Didn't he make a movie about a flood?
Flood.
Is that the same one? Changeling? That's a good movie he made. All these famous Clint Eastwood movies.
Changeling. I know Outlaw Josey Wells, Dirty Hair. I know that, yeah.
Well, do you know the Clint Eastwood who gets in Esquire magazine talks about how great Donald Trump is?
You said, Thomas, I read some of that. I don't like the language that he uses. I like his Westerns best. Like him better than his interviews, because in the Westerns, he don't hardly talk at all. He don't say nothing. He just looks mean and shoots people.
Well, in Esquire, he says that this is the, he says, where everybody's tired of political correctness. Kissing up. This is a kiss-ass generation we're in right now. We're really in a pussy generation.
I say now, I don't want to hear it from you.
I don't know
that's
a gendered term. I don't know if he thought, maybe I could say, I mean, he'd said it already. You didn't have to...
He's an 86-year-old man. He's going to run at the mouth. That's what you get to that age, you're allowed to do that. So as far as I'm concerned, you know, he ain't being racist or whatever, but if I don't like the language, don't...
He said, everybody's walking on eggshells. We see people accusing people of being racist and all kinds of stuff. When I grew up, those things weren't called racist. He grew up in the 30s?
Something, a long time ago, yeah.
A lot of stuff wasn't called racist back then.
Man, just some of it was, but it wasn't. They didn't have, you know, not everybody back then is pointing a finger, calling it what it was.
Back then, if there'd been the internet, there'd be think pieces like, are colored water fountains really racist?
Right.
Like, we have it here, and they have it here. It's just, to me, it's equitable. What they'd say. Let me clarify. That's what they would say in the blogs of the 30s.
Yeah.
If there was a Breitbart in the 30s, they'd say, can you believe these SJWs saying that these water fountains are racist. See, I didn't even say the word again that time.
I don't Maybe even know Clint Eastwood's right. I don't back know. Back then, there was some shameful stuff went on down here in the South. I ain't proud of it. I know a lot of people ain't. So be it.
Well, when Clint Eastwood and Donald Trump get in office, it looks like it's going to be a different world.
Clint Eastwood getting in office, what? That's a good movie, too. A different world. No, Perfect World. Perfect World.
Oh, that's a good one. Different World is a good show. That's a good show.
Who did that show?
That's the show that came on after Cosby. Mm-hmm. I've said the P word.
All right. Don't go down
the list. A C word.
I don't want it.
And then another C word. I've derailed this show three different times. Twice because of Clint Eastwood and once because of Bill Cosby.
Well, Clint Eastwood, he ain't ever been what he called politically correct. He ain't ever done that. Gran Torino just says awful things to those
He gets
Asian
a script
people.
And it's not politically correct and it has a lot of racial epithets. He cannot get in front of the cameras fast enough. And he can shoot a movie. He does, sometimes he does like half a take.
Yeah.
He stops it. He's like, you know what? We got enough of this. And then they just move on.
I want to go see that Shelly. It's an airplane. Tom, Hank Forrest Gump. Yeah, Shelly. That'll probably be, he'll be saying, Lord knows what he'll be calling Asian people on that flight.
If you can make the Sully Sullenberger story politically incorrect, then Donald Trump is going to do it. And he's going to have Tom Hanks up there. America's sweetheart. He was America's beloved uncle before Tim Kaine came into the picture. That's who Tom Hanks should be playing is Tim Kaine.
Donald Trump ain't got nothing to do with making that movie. You make Clint Eastwood. You said Donald
Why
Trump.
Can I not get Clint Eastwood's name right?
He's older than Clint Eastwood. No, Clint Eastwood older than Donald Trump. Now you
Christ.
Got me doing it. Just...
Let's just move on. We can't talk about real quick Bradley Cooper. We never got to talk about this. He was at the Democratic National Convention. Bradley Cooper who started American Sniper.
That's Clint Eastwood movie.
Clint Eastwood
I like
movie.
That one.
Politically incorrect. Just shooting and sniping all over the place.
Now, he was at the DNC?
Yeah.
Did he have his gun with him?
I don't think so.
And I don't know what he was doing there either then.
And today is President Barack Obama's birthday.
Yeah,
I know
yeah.
you'll want to join Clint Eastwood, Tom Hanks, Sully Sullenberger.
Clint Eastwood is singing happy birthday to a Debbie chair
Allen.
Somewhere, sitting around. Just
chairs, do chairs. Just, and that's the news. I don't know if that one went so well.
No. Because of the language. You, Clint Eastwood started, you had to add on to it. I'm tired of it. Oh, hell, why did they ain't got to play all the animal sounds? It ain't the one damn thing. Good Lord. All right, snake of the day two. Snake of the day two. Here, to just show it real quick. I won't get over it. This snake here called Alfonso. Yeah, snake of the day two.
That's a picture of Jake the Snake Roberts.
Oh.
I don't know what you did to Julie.
I didn't do nothing to Julie. I don't need to. She needs to apologize to me. It's a misunderstanding is what it is.
Something's wrong.
Well, I know something's wrong. I don't want to sit here and show pictures of snakes all day. That's not what I had in mind when I was thinking about doing this. But I'm going to have a lot. I may not be able to fool a good Nashville lawyer, but I may be able to find one around here local. That'll look at that paper I signed. I'll see what I can do about it. But for now, I got to do what I got to do, I guess. I don't know.
You got a sponsor?
Yeah, oh, I got a good sponsor. Oh, we got a good sponsor on here. And it's delicious. We like to eat them for dessert, little treat, you know, something sweet on your mouth. After dinner, you know, after lunch, anything time, you want something sweet in it. Your dead granny's soft cookies. That's right. Your dead granny's soft cookies. Ain't no better way to remember her. That's right. Dead granny soft cookies. Put them in your mouth. They're awful soft and they're awful sweet.
Got a sponsor tonight, Jackie, that I think you're really going to like. Bread sack full of chili back again tonight. Bread sack full of chili. That sack sipping, cracker dipping lunchtime treat.
Mm.
Remember, comes in three flavors. Spicy, runny, and for dogs. So that's bread sack full of chili, that sack sipping, cracker dipping lunchtime treat. Folks, we hope you enjoyed Evening Folks this week.
Next week, there won't be no language, and we'll try to get the news better. That news ain't my section. That's your section. So that messed up. I sold the snakes, even though I didn't want to. I did that good. I did the school bus drive, except you kept. So I'm holding up on my end.
Something was happening. I couldn't. Every time I tried to say Clint Eastwood's name, it didn't work. I can't remember. I swear he made a movie about a flood, somebody drowning or something like that, but I may be mixing up Angelina Jolie movies. Right. Then I said I used some outdated language, which is historically correct, but I think it ground things to a halt. Also saying pussy, that was kind of weird.
All right, I don't want to hear it.
And even though I'm quoting him, and then...
Why are you doing it again?
And
you
then saying Bill Cosby, that ruins everything.
You did it.
They're about the
twice.
Same age.
You didn't. It was bad enough. You did it the first time. I had to do it again at the end. I'm just saying goodbye. We're going to try to do better next time. Next week, try to do better. Thank you for winding down with us. Sorry about all the language. Try not to talk about, if we're going to talk about Clint Eastwood from here on out, let's just talk about Pale Rider, something I like.
Pale Rider
is good. I like that one. Oh, what's the one where he adopts a monkey? He adopts it.
Was that officially, an actual adopt? Like he went through,
got that monkey. He had to fight somebody.
Like he had the paperwork.
After he fought the person, he won the papers on the monkey. It took him in. Yeah.
Yeah, but was he like, red like?
It's his daddy. That was his boy. I mean, they were family. You could see on there. Yeah. Don't forget to subscribe. Hell.